हेलो एंड वेलकम टू मैजिक इन माय फूड. दिस इज़ ज्योति डालमिया. यस, आई हैव बीन मिसिंग यू ऑल अ लॉट एंड आई नो यू पीपल आल्सो मिस्ड माय वॉइस. आई नेवर न्यू आई वुड बी गेटिंग सो मच ऑफ लव इन माय मेल्स, इन माय मैसेंजर्स, इन माय मैसेजेस एंड आई एम ट्रूली ब्लेस्ड फॉर इट. यू नो मैजिक इन माय फूड हैज़ अ निश इन लो कार्ब कीटो रेसिपीज, especially the Indian keto recipes. I have created a lot of Indian recipes into the keto version and I am loved for it and I really feel overwhelmed for that. And today, from today onwards, I would love to share some more innovative and creative recipes. And today's recipe is to the hilt, you can say. It is a keto mixture which is also a Faryali mixture and you are going to love it because it has one ingredient which is a protein rich and very less carb, in fact zero, almost zero carb you can say, because it is full of fiber and it is very healthy even. And this will make your keto life much easier because this is one recipe which you can carry also as a travel food and can be stored even for 1 month, yes, at normal room temperature, and you're going to just fall for it. So let's begin with it. This awesome, delicious, super tasty keto Faryali mixture, yes, I'm making in two ways, that is your salt and the sweet flavor, so that you can taste whichever flavor you like to have. And for that we'll begin directly with the heating of the pan. Add some clarified butter. If you are vegan, add your vegan oil or vegan butter and simply heat the ghee or the butter properly. And here comes the super ingredients. Yes, this is the gum arabica, which is very rich in protein and is full of fiber. It has no carbs in it. Just stir it on, or you have to fry this gum arabica. They will pop up and let it fry on medium flame to high flame so that it gets cooked up properly from inside, so that it becomes fluffed up from inside. You have to cook it up properly. Just stir it and slowly it will cook up from inside. See how beautiful it looks. Lovely. From transparent gum arabica, it has become fluffy white balls. Yes. See, now my gum arabica has fried up and I'm going to take it out. It has properly fluffed up and take it out on a plate. Well, usually we take out such stuff on a tissue paper, but we are not bothered so much about the fat content, so I'm taking it out normally on the plate because we want fats in our diet. We love fats. See, I've just taken it out, and after taking this gum arabica from the oil or from the ghee or the butter, see how it looks beautiful, fluffy. I'm going to remove half of the oil of it, or the ghee out of it, or the butter out of it, whatever you are using. And I'm dropping some curry leaves to give the flavor to my salty mixture. So just fry up the curry leaves even, so that it becomes crispy and crunchy. I tell you, this gives an awesome taste to the mixture. When you have, you really feel happiness inside yourself. So just fry it up and when it becomes crispy, just take it out. Yes, it's done and I'm taking it out. See, lovely green color. So enticing. I love the curry leaves as it is only. It's a good snacking. I just use these curry leaves and I fry it and I add some spices, salt and all, and I use it as a snack even. Very good snack option. And now we begin with the frying of other ingredients. So here I'm dropping the peanuts and I'm going to fry it. In fact, I'm going to roast it in oil or ghee, butter. I'll say butter better for me, or ghee, because I'm using ghee. And with this mini slicer, I have just sliced the almonds. Yes. And you can visit my Amazon store for that even. Please do visit my Amazon store, from where you can buy any stuff or buy your stuff even. That would help promoting magic in my food to survive. So these are your sliced almonds, which I'm going to drop into it. This would give a added flavor. Instead of putting the whole almonds, it's better to slice and put, because the texture plays an important role in your mixture. So I'm just sauteing it a bit. Saute it for 2 minutes and it would be crisp, because it would become half crisp actually, because I'm going to add other ingredients even. So while those also get cooked up or fried or become crispy, the ingredients which I've added earlier will also become more crispy. So you have to add the ingredients in the order which takes more time to cook or becomes crispy. I've added first. See, I'm adding this dried coconut. This I had got the half shells, you can say, the coconut one, the coconut dried meat, and I have just sliced it through the same slicer and I've just chopped it or broken with my fingers only into small pieces, or you can cut it with a knife even. I'm just sauteing it. This would become brown in color, but I'm not going to make it properly brown because it's going to get cooked up with other ingredients also. So you have to maintain that balance of sauteing so that it does not get burnt. See, I'm just checking it's properly cooked and I'm just sauteing it a bit, and I have shut the stove and I'm going to let it cool down a bit. While it gets cooled, it will also become more crispy and more brown. Now I've taken a big bowl, because now comes the mixing part of all the ingredients. So I've taken a big mixing bowl. I'm adding the fried gum arabica into it and I'm going to crush it a bit with the help of the crusher. You can use a small bowl, even a steel bowl, to crush it. Whatever you feel comfortable, you can use that. I have to crush it a bit so that it becomes a mixture type. See, so I'm just crushing it a bit. I don't want a powder form. Don't use a mixer grinder for it. And now I'm adding the stuff from the wok. So see, they look so lovely, golden yellow in color. Really tempting to have this, but before that I have to make the mixture. So just mix it up. Mix it up properly so that the gum arabic and all the ingredients gets interlinked into each other. Intermingle. I'm making a marriage of the gum arabica with the other ingredients. See, they look like a homogeneous mixture. And now I'm going to divide it into two. Yes, you remember I told you I'm making it a sweet mixture and a salty mixture. So I'm just dividing into two portions. It all depends upon you. You can make more of the sweet one or more of the salty one, whatever you want. And now I'm adding to the bigger bowl, I'm adding the salt. Yes, this one I'm making a savory mixture. So I'm adding salt to it. I'm adding some black pepper into it. You can add chaat powder even into it, but I don't like the chaat flavor, so I'm not adding that. And here comes the fried curry leaves. Yes. Just crush it while dropping so that it adds flavor to all the portion of the mixture. You can add more even if you want. I'm adding little this much only. And see, when I'm going to toss, then also it will get crushed. So you don't have to crush it into fine pieces. You should have the bite of the curry leaves also. That will give a beautiful taste to your taste bud. And just mix it up. Doesn't it look beautiful? I tell you, this mixture has become a perfect snack for me in the evening with my tea. I love it like anything. And I'm telling you, even my family who's not on keto, they also enjoy this. And this is a very good mixture for your fasting even, that is your Navratri, or for your any fast you do where you don't have the normal food, you can have this. This is perfect. My savory mixture is done. I can store it in an airtight container for at least 1 month. And now comes the preparation of the sweet mixture. So for this, I am adding the sugar-free stevia. You can add erythritol or a combination of sweeteners you prefer. And some cardamom powder. This will enhance the flavor of the mixture, the sweet mixture. See, it's so easy. And I know it, when you prepare it, you're going to just love it and you're going to just fall for it. And this is going to be a go snack for you. Yes, gum arabica, which we never thought is a keto friendly, is a keto friendly ingredient. I had already posted one recipe of gum arabica previously, gum arabica fudge, of which the link has been provided above. You can check it out. And now comes the tasting time of the sweet one. Did I taste the salty one? I don't remember. But this is too delicious. And I would say it's difficult to stop at this much. But this can also be stored in different containers. Don't store together, because one is sweet and one is salt. So store it differently. And a perfect carry food, perfect travel food. And it can be eaten for 1 month. It won't get rancid. Yes, store it in an airtight container. And perfect keto snacks for your journey. So if you have liked it and enjoyed it, please go and subscribe to my channel and post comments and queries. I would love to answer it. Thank you.